Hey guys, Hastings here, and welcome to highlights from round 5, the final round of the Mini Cooper Cup. This time we've headed back to the Silverstone circuit to race on the national layout configuration-y thingamajig. And fittingly, for the last round, I had my best qualifying of the series, starting on second on the left hand of the screen there. It's the first time I've managed to get on the front row, so I was pretty happy with that, splitting the two SAP racing cars that pretty much dominated the series so far. My teammate was fourth as well, so a good showing from my TBC racing teammate and myself. And hopefully we'd have a pretty decent weekend. You can see though in the back of shot there, my teammate didn't exactly have the best of starts, dropping back two positions by the time, three positions there by the time we get to turn two. And you can also see some very big rolls caused by what I presume was a lag spike towards the back of the grid. Following my teammate down now, he's going to be down the back straight now, looking to try and regain a position or two, trying to get past the yellow car that you see in front of him. Again, it's another newcomer to the championship, just turning up for the one final round, and didn't have a time to make a paint, but he's managed to get my teammate there, he's managed to get the move done on the yellow car, and he's back up into fifth position, I believe, so just one position lower than he started, which I guess isn't too bad, but obviously I'm a bit higher up at the moment, so I want him to come and join me and see if he can help out. Maybe we can get a double podium for the team if he can work his way back through. But we'll see later on. Just behind them, the white-based privateer car and the Lap Sorso car running within a very close vicinity of each other. That was a bit of a mouthful. I could have definitely chosen some much easier words. But the white car there, you can see, has gone up the inside into turn two. And they're joined by the yellow car there, as I presume he outbraked himself into the corner and fell back into their clutches. The green car, though, the Lap Sorso car, managed to get a much better run around the outside of turn two and has about a car length in front by the time they get to penultimate corner, and he's also got the inside line for that corner as well. He's stuck in the middle of the middle of nowhere there, though, because the yellow car's right in front of him, trying to hold in the track that he wants to be in. That gives the white car the incentive to try and get back past as they go round onto the pit straight, and he does indeed have the inside line as they come over the line now and come towards turn one. Turn one is not a position that you want to be going too wide in, and indeed the white car slightly backed out of it a little bit, and the didn't really need to, as the green car went miles wide on turn one. You can really get away with it here because of the huge runoff area. Three wide though as they go into turn two. I think there's a little bit of contact between the three of them there. You see the ARM car's kind of got involved in this little battle. See if he can make his way through the field. It's the white car that's now leading this battle though as they come down the back straight, although they're looking to go three wide once again as they go into the penultimate corner. The ARM car's up the inside there, but if he can hold it there, he does. Oh, there's contact, and there's more contact. Luckily, it wasn't too heavy. And so the ARM car is now on the outside as they go around the hairpin. The Lap Sorso car, if he can tuck in behind... if he can tuck in behind the white car, but he's actually got the inside of the white car, and they're three wide again as they come round sort of the final kink onto the pit straight. The ARM car stuck out wide there. It looks like he's going to drop back slightly before they get to turn one. And these guys, there's a bit more contact. Again, it wasn't too serious. So the ARM car is going very wide out on the exit of turn one, as so are other few other cars in the background. The Lap Sorso car seems to have got the move done on the white-based privateer car. And that's all we're going to see of that battle for the time being. Out in front, the SAP racing car that had started third managed to jump myself, but I was still holding on there in the podium positions. The two guys in front of me were starting to fight it out a little bit, so I was just able to hold my position just behind them. You can see I can give them the little nudge to the car in front of me as he's slowing me down a bit through the hairpin. The SAP racing cars definitely had a little bit more pace than me at this stage of the race, but because they were fighting amongst themselves a fair bit, I was just about holding my position behind them. And you can see, when I went through the hairpin and gave the car in front of me a little bit of a bump, I had the odd opportunity, sort of a half-assed move, to try and get past. But I was pretty happy running in third position. And you can see there also my teammates managed to get past, I think it was the no sponsor racing car that was previously holding fourth. The top four though were separated by not a particularly huge amount. And you can see that the number 8 car has a pretty decent run through turn 2. And I believe he's going to go and try and make a move into the penultimate corner. There's just the four main corners on this track. So you come out of turn 2 and then go into the penultimate one. But he's up the inside as they go through said penultimate corner. Though that does mean he's going to be on the outside now for the final corner, which is this very long sweeping and tightening hairpin. It's a very difficult complex of corners to get right. You can see there, I'd actually made a little bit of a mistake running wide out of turn 2. And instead of attacking the back of the SAP cars, I would now be defending rather heavily from my teammate. So at the top four now, we're sort of two miniature groups of two, with the number 22 SAP racing car defending from his teammate, and me sat in third defending from my teammate. So very interesting to see who was going to be on the podium and who was going to be in what position on the podium, as all three positions were definitely up for grabs at this stage. Again, the number 8 car has a pretty decent run into turn 2. He's up the inside as they go through the corner. But the way that this corner is, if you're on the outside here, you can get a much better run onto the back straight if you're on the outside line. So you can see that the number 8 car was well up the inside and alongside his teammate as they went through turn 2. But by the time they get to the next corner, he's just dropped back because his teammate had a much better run through the corner and was able to carry more speed as they went on to the back straight. The number 8 car though managed to get up the inside as they go around the final corner, and he's on the inside as they go around the kink onto the pitch straight. Off the screen at the moment, he's still up the inside. Can he hold it there? Well, he can, but there's a huge great lag spike which throws them both into the gravel trap. Very, very unfortunate there for the SAP racing cars. Although, I personally can't complain too much, because that made me inherit the lead. I was still defending somewhat heavily from my teammate. You can see there's a little bit more of a gap there now than there was earlier. But TBC Racing now had a 1-2 position. I don't think this is the first time we've been in a 1-2 position. I think we were briefly in Prague. But there always seems to have been something that means one of us has had a bad race or dropped back a few positions. Like at Prague, when my teammate got spun by a bump 2 laps in a row. So now, assuming that a lag spike doesn't strike our team in the same way it did the SAP Racing team, hopefully, fingers crossed, we can go on and take a 1-2 for the team in this final race. Obviously, I want me to be the winner in this race, but the team is definitely more important at this stage. Or maybe, anyway. Depends if I win or not, I suppose. But anyway, now the battle for third was between... I think this is the battle for third. I'm not sure where the SAP racing cars filled back in. But anyway, there's a battle between the no-sponsor racing team and the yellow privateer car. The yellow car manages to get past as they go down towards turn two, but it looks like the no-sponsor racing car's had a decent entry into turn two, and he's had a much better exit, even though he's on that inside line. That's quite contrary to what I was saying earlier about getting a decent run with an outside line. Although saying that, they're still well and truly side by side as they go down towards the penultimate corner. And it looks like the yellow car's going to make it up the inside. Yes, he is. Although it looks like he's gone a little bit deep. The white car looking like he might be able to have a better run through the hairpin. Not sure that he's going to be able to do much. Although he is on the inside as they come to the exit of the corner. And he decides that he doesn't really want to fight it too much. He's going to dive in and take his pit stop. Back to the front now, and the gap between me and my teammate had stayed pretty consistent throughout the lap. It sort of just gets a little bit bigger in places, and we sort of squeeze up in places as well. But generally, it didn't seem as though one of us was significantly quicker than the other at all. We were both running around the same sort of pace, and I was very happy with that, in fact, as my teammate had kind of been dominating me in the standings so far. I think there's it'd been very rarely have I really been on pace to properly compete with my teammate. So this time out, to be able to hold him behind and not be having to defend constantly, it was a really good feeling. Although I am having to defend in places, I'm quick enough so that it's not, I'll go defensive into every single corner. I can just use the pace that I have around this track, and with a few sort of altered lines here and there when I need to. It was actually turned into a really, really good race. Obviously, it is very disappointing about the lag spike on the SAP racing cars, but I just can't complain from a personal perspective, because I'm now winning this race. I'm having a great battle with my teammate, trying to keep him behind me, and potentially on for my first win of the series. I haven't won a race yet in this series, and potentially a first 1-2 for the team. So at this stage of the race, it is looking very promising for me and my teammate and our team. But like I said, it is still, we haven't even had a pit stop yet, but the pit stop has got to be taken between, I think it was lap 6 and lap 12 out of 18 laps. So we're only about halfway through the race now. A few people have come into the pits, but not everybody. Going back to one of the SAP racing cars now that you can see on screen, he's looking at working his way back through the field. See the yellow privateer car, the new guy in this round, got caught on a curb and spun himself out after turn one. Very unfortunate for him. But the SAP racing car wasn't fussed about that, because that means he's gained one more position back on his way working himself back through the field. And he wasn't stopping there. You can see he's got a lap Sorso car in his sights. He moves to the inside and tries to go up the inside to the penultimate corner, and he manages to get it done. I think that doesn't look right. I don't know if the gravel trap didn't load in the graphics or something. But yes, that was a very good move by the SAP racing car, diving up the inside in the left-hander and managing to hold it there before they got to the hairpin. Again, a lap Sorso car thinks, this guy's quicker than me, there's no point fighting with him, I'll just dive in the pits and save us both some time. The other SAP racing car was also trying to make his way through the field. It's currently stuck in between one of the ARM cars and the white privateer car. That's the one. I knew that, really, definitely. And like his teammate, he was obviously trying to make up as many positions as quickly as possible to try and get as close to the front of the grid as he can. He has a pretty good run out of turn two. Just like his teammate, it looks like he's going to try and have the inside line up into the penultimate corner. If he can hold it there, can he outbreak this guy? He can, just like his teammate. He's gone up the inside. But unlike his teammate, it doesn't look like he's going to manage to hold it, because he went very deep into the corner. And yeah, the ARM car seems to be slightly ahead as they go through the hairpin, but it does look like the SAP car's got a tighter line. Come round the exit of the corner and the ARM car is back in front. Looking like this SAP racing car is having a slightly harder time of it than his teammate getting back through the field. He'll probably have another go maybe into turn two. I don't think he's close enough to go have a go at turn one. It's not exactly a particularly good overtaking opportunity either. Down into turn two, you can get a move done if you're alongside, but I don't think he's close enough at this point. Taking the wider line, trying to get a better run onto the back straight. Looks like it might have worked for him as they are side by side again. This time the SAP racing car is on the outside going down into turn two, although he's already a car's length in front by the time they're about halfway down the straight. He does move to go slightly defensive into the corner as well, hoping this time he doesn't run too wide and give that position back. It doesn't exactly look like the best line through that corner. That ARM car is definitely looking at trying to get back past. There's a little bit of a touch between them there. The ARM car is well and truly up the inside, and he's taken the position back again. See the white car running slightly wide in the background, trying to get onto the back of this fight and join in if he can. But once again, it's the ARM car that leads as they go across the line to complete another lap. SAP racing car again will be looking to try and see if he can make the same move that he did on the last lap. He's definitely looking a lot closer this time around. He might even be able to get the move done as they go into turn two, rather than taking that sort of a cut back line. Or he is looking at a wider line on the entry to the corner, on the exit to the corner. He's cutting back towards the inside, although he hasn't this time. No, he hasn't. I'm talking rubbish. He's taken that wider line, though it doesn't seem to have worked for him. That was an interesting one. I thought he was going to cut back and take the same line as he did last time, but it turns out he just pretty much just followed the ARM car's wheel tracks. Although this time into turn three, I suppose it is, penultimate corner, he has dived up the inside of the ARM car, because he got slowed down by the lap Sorso car, and he's on the inside of the hairpin this time. That lap Sorso cars definitely made these things interesting. That's an interesting move there. The SAP car manages to make it stick this time around. And he's looking at going around the outside of the lap Sorso car, around the kink, onto the pit straight. And the ARM car is looking to go past as well. That lap Sorso car is getting completely mugged. You do not want to be going too wide around that first corner. And indeed, the lap Sorso car went very wide. That's interesting. That lap Sorso car there seemed very slow, almost if he had some sort of engine damage or something. But we're running on cosmetic damage settings, so there shouldn't be any damage that would cause the car to go any slower. That was a really interesting one. I'm not quite sure why that happened there. Moving back to the fight at the front, I was still just about holding my teammate behind. I believe at this stage of the race, we've both made our pit stop already. I was actually quite confused about my teammate's tactics. I decided that all the time he sat behind me, I'm not going to pit. Because if I pit and he pits in a really good lap, then he'll jump me while I'm in the pits. So I thought, I'll just wait until he goes in the pits and then I'll go in the lap after. And he didn't pit, so I pitted on the very last lap of the pit window on lap 12, and so did my teammate. He just followed me straight through. Obviously, because we are running cosmetic damage, you don't actually stop in a pit box, and you just run down the pit lane. But it does create an interesting strategical choice. Like I said, if I'd pitted a lap earlier, and my teammate had put in a really fast lap, and I'd had a really slow out lap, he probably would have jumped me for position. So that's something I was really worried about at this stage. But no, so it was an interesting choice by my teammate there. I don't know if he's sort of easing off a little bit, not trying too hard just to make sure that we get the 1-2. Because if we'd come out side by side and had an accident or something, or if there'd been a lag spike side by side, then obviously our race would be pretty screwed over. Just like the SAP racing cars. Oh, the SAP racing team earlier on. You can see one of the SAP racing cars there in the back of shot a minute ago, working his way back up into third position. So he's definitely showing his pace, even if he's not currently at the front of the grid. I'd still managed to hold my teammate behind me for the time being. You can see just how close he's getting at points in this race. He's definitely slightly closer than he was a few laps ago. I think the gap just ever so slightly, just closing inch by inch, lap by lap. But it's definitely going to culminate in a very interesting finish. Well, obviously I can say that because I know what's happened already, but even from an impartial view, at this stage in the race, it's looking like it could be a very interesting finish. I'm taking the more defensive lines now into the third turn there, the penultimate turn. And again, just hogging that inside line as I go around the hairpin, trying to keep it as tight as possible, not allowing my teammate to dive up the inside, but at the same time, trying to get straight as quickly as possible on the exit of the turn so I can get the power down as quickly as possible. And still there, we're pretty much nose to tail as we come down across the pit straight. Teammate having a look, maybe trying to go up the inside of the first turn, but again, not quite close enough. I was starting to really struggle with turn one at this point in the race, so it was something that was really bugging me, because I was quite happy with most of the track. I quite like this configuration of track, but for some reason, like defending from my teammate, I kept pushing too hard into turn one and getting stuck out on the curb on the outside. But fortunately, because of the nice lot of runoff you get there, it wasn't hurting my defensive race. And once again, you can see that my teammate is very close behind me. I don't take quite such a defensive line this time. There's a slightly bigger gap. And we seem to take very different lines through that penultimate corner. You can see that I went sort of braked a bit later and went a lot wider on the exit, whereas my teammate sort of braked a lot earlier and cut a lot tighter on the exit. But it didn't really make a huge amount of difference lap time-wise. You can see that my teammate is still just as close as ever on the pit straight. You can see running wide as he sort of scraped along my rear bumper there. This is probably the closest he's been all race. See, I'm taking a very defensive line there, almost cutting across the grass on the inside of turn one. And once again, my teammate is just so close. If I wasn't there, he would be driving straight through me. But because I am there, I'm just managing to hold him behind. It's a good job that collisions are in fact turned on for this race. If this was qualifying and the collisions are turned off, he'd be driving straight through me, I'm sure. And I think this is definitely his best opportunity so far. It looks like he's side by side with me as we go down the back straight. Not quite close enough to be making a move. I've got the defensive line. And you can see there, once again, the slight difference in our lines through that corner. I end up with a much tighter line into the hairpin. My teammate managed to get a much wider exit and turn in. I can park it on the apex, though, and he gives me a little love tap between teammates. It's not the first time that's happened in this series, that's for sure. And once again, he's very, very close as we come down onto the pit straight. Not quite as close as he was this time last lap, but still within striking distance should I make any type of small error. But fortunately I don't, and that was actually the last lap, I forgot to mention. So I did just about manage to hang on and take my first race victory of the series. I'm very, very happy with that one. Further back there would still be some close position fights going on. You can see the yellow car that is making his debut in this race, looking to try and get past the white privateer car. And also you can see in the background there, the Lapsorso car is also fighting with the Powermax racing car that we haven't really seen much of in this race. But that's not the battle that we are focusing on. We're focusing on this one between the yellow privateer and the white privateer. And it was a very close finish as they come across the line. And it's the yellow car that just about takes the position on the line. Very close finishing there indeed. Race 2 would be starting from a reverse grid race. From qualifying, so that meant I would be starting very near the back of the grid. The only people behind me were the pole sitter from race 1 and a few people that missed qualifying. Away we go though for the start of the very final race of the series. I got a fairly decent getaway. I'm currently alongside one of the SAT racing cars in the background, but that's not where we're going to be focusing on at the moment. You see everyone piling through the first corner. It's a very quick first corner. It's amazing that everyone got through here cleanly. And also very fortunate there are no lag spikes this time, although one car is still flying off into the gravel. Oh, there's two actually. There's one on either side of the grid. Completely missed that. And no sponsor racing car seems to have had a very good start, though. I think he started sort of mid-pack and has worked his way up a few positions. As we swap the screen now, if I can get my words out, yeah, you could see that my teammate was going very sideways. I think that was sort of contact-induced. And there's a huge, great group of cars piling down into the third turn. I think there's three sets of cars going two by two into this corner. My teammate being one of them going past one of the ARM racing cars. You can see I'm there just in the background, just a few cars later, running very wide through the hairpin on this particular lap. ARM car though would still be alongside my teammate as they come down towards the kink onto the pit straight. I would actually have the inside line as they go down towards the first corner, also with the SAP racing car there looking to get involved as well if he can. SAP racing car's not quite close enough and they're going side by side around the first corner. I've said before that's not the best way to happen. My teammate gets squeezed out along onto the curb and the ARM car is still on his right hand side as they go down towards turn two. They're making it three wide now. Who's last on the latest on the brakes? Looks like my teammate was one of the latest of brakes and he's stuck on the outside there. There's a little bit of a lag spike there. Some people have gone ghosted. I think my teammate has managed to gain the position from the ARM car. He has indeed. Let's hope he's got a decent enough run so he can defend into the next corner. I think this is further up the grid now. You can see the two privateers cars that finished very closely were still very close on track as they go down into turn three in this second race. These guys must get fed up of fighting each other at this rate. But it looks like the Lapsorso car is going to get involved as well. I think the yellow car might have been able to have the position of the white car there, but the Lapsorso car got involved and kind of ruined his run through the hairpin. Although they're still side by side as they go through the kink onto the start-finish straight. The yellow car has gone up the inside, but they're still too wide as they run over the line and down towards the first turn. No, the yellow car has actually managed to get in front. Oh, crikey, that was close. The white car just about cutting in front of the green and black Lapsorso car there. I could have sworn there was going to be a bit of contact. That had been a bit of contact there going out into turn one. That could have been absolute carnage. They're still almost too wide, though, as they go into turn two. Just looks like the white privateer car has got the position from the Lapsorso car. You can see in the background there, you've got one of the SAP racing cars coming to join the fun. And we go to ride along board with him now. Or the camera's focused on him anyway. Are you looking to go up the inside of the lap sourcer car into turn three? I didn't think he was going to make that, but he has indeed. The lap sourcer car just running a little bit wide. I don't know if he was avoiding somebody else in front of him. But whatever the circumstance, the SAP racing car has managed to get in position. There's so many cars running very close together there. You can see at the back of the train, there's a little bit of a gap back towards me. I got held up somewhere at some point, and I was just behind the train of cars that in front of me that included my teammate. The SAP racing car now looking to make another position as he goes up the inside of the wide privateer. Got too wide on the first corner again. That is really not the best idea. And this time, they both managed to stay on track. That's very impressive driving for the privateer car and the SAP racing car driver there. Very impressive indeed. Very impressive overtake from the SAP racing car there. If he'd understeered out wide into the privateer car, that could have been a relatively big accident. Looks like everybody's filing now into single file as they go down the pitch straight, or the back straight even. Well, the ARM car is running very close to the back of the privateer car in front, and he's got a SAP racing car with him for good measure. Almost all the SAP racing car's looking to try and go past, but he's got nowhere to go. The ARM car flies down the inside. The white privateer car looking to try and get a cut back, but the ARM car has managed to park it on the apex and hold his position. Feel sorry, a bit sorry for that SAP racing car there, looking to try and make an overtake on either car, but couldn't make either overtake because the other car was in the way of either one. If that kind of makes sense. Don't think it does, but I knew what I meant. Anyway, the privateer car would not be looking to give up the position too easily and was having a little bit of a look, see if he could go up the inside down to turn one, but just a little bit too far back on this occasion to do anything about it. Moving back up a few positions now, and the other SAP racing car was still making moves in this race, going this time up the inside into turn two of the no sponsor racing car, and it looks like the ARM car is going to follow him through, although this no sponsor car is running on that wider line, doesn't manage to get the better run on this occasion though. You can see there, thanks for hosting livery, that is aimed at me for hosting this championship. And I'm told that because it's aimed at me, I've got to pay for a sort of advertising privilege. I'm not so sure about that one. We'll definitely be debating that with their team manager in the near future. But I appreciate the sentiment, so thank you very much to those No Sponsor Racing guys. I've really enjoyed hosting this series, and I'm just glad that you've enjoyed racing in it. Anyway, footnote aside, as it were, we'll go back to talking about the racing now. And the No Sponsor Racing car sat in the middle of a group there that he's not particularly going to be able to do much in. I think sat behind a SAP racing car, it's very difficult to go forward. Those guys really are very quick. But also at the same time, it looks like he's got a big enough gap back to the car behind him, so that even though he's running in very close vicinity with two other cars, or relatively close anyway, he's not really going to be able to do much attacking, and he's not going to have to do much defending either. So although he's in a very interesting position there, not a huge amount of interesting racing. Although he is definitely looking at trying to sort of take not necessarily your normal racing lines to see if he can maybe show himself in the mirror of the car in front, force him into a mistake or something. But it doesn't look like anything's going to be happening in the near future. Unless, of course, the SAP racing car gets caught up on the car in front of him, maybe he might be able to do something. But again, I'm not sure that that's necessarily going to be the best thing to do. One of the main reasons I'm currently following the SAP racing car is because there's a good battle in front of the no sponsor racing car, sorry, but yeah, there's a good battle in front and there's a good battle behind, so if you follow the car in the middle, we might be able to see both battles. And you can see in the background my teammate is going up the inside of the privateer car. Both of these guys have gone too wide through the first corner with other people in this race, and they're going too wide with each other now as they run down towards turn two. I think my teammate has got the inside line, and he has just about managed to get in front by the time they get to the corner. Can he take a decent line out of the corner? He can, and he's definitely made that move stick. I think that the no sponsor racing car that we're following at the moment had a pretty poor run through that turn two. As you can see, just how close my teammate is now. The no sponsor racing car was definitely a lot further in front a short while ago. One of the SAP racing cars there was facing the wrong way on the edge of the track. I presume there was a bit of contact up ahead, but unfortunately we didn't see it. Going down into the final kink now, as they go onto the pitch straight. doesn't look like anyone's running too wide. Oh, someone is running too wide. There's a no sponsor racing car running too wide with one of the ARM cars as they go into turn one. The Lapsusa car running very wide, as is the no sponsor racing car. But like I said earlier, lots of runoff there, so it's very easy to get away with it. I think those guys up ahead are still too wide as they go down towards turn two. No, the ARM car is in front, but the Lapsusa car has definitely thrown himself back up the inside, and it looks like he's got the position back with the ARM car running really rather wide now, losing a fair few positions. He's now side by side with the no sponsor racing car. How many positions is that he's lost? He lost one back to the Lapsusa car, one to the yellow privateer car, one to the no sponsor racing car. Maybe, can he? It does look like he's going to lose this position. He's stuck. He's on the inside, but he's going to be stuck on the outside for the hairpin. And he just about manages to slot back in ahead of my teammate. Although my teammate is looking like he's going to be up the inside on the exit of the corner now. Not quite sure. I can't see from this angle. It looks like they're going too wide. I think my teammate is just a little bit further back. Yeah, it looks like the ARM car has just about managed to hold his position for now. Lapsusa racing car still defending out front there. People seem to be taking liberties now with how wide they're running at this first corner, using all of the runoff to their advantage. But the car that we're following now made some moves. He was sat behind that SAP racing car earlier. He's now out in front. And the Lapsusa car defending very hard for second. You got the yellow privateer car, I think, currently holding third, and we're riding on board with the no sponsor racing car in fourth. These guys are fighting tooth and nail at the moment. I think this is going to be one hell of a close finish. I do believe this is the very last lap. And look at that, you got the Lapsusa racing car squeezing the yellow privateer car onto the grass on the inside of the track. The no sponsor racing car is running side by side with the ARM car. My teammate's got a pretty good run out of the corner as well. My teammate's around the outside of the no sponsor racing car there, and he's looks like, I can't tell, he was side by side with the Lapsusa car as he went across the line. Crikey, that was a close finish. This is how close that finish was. This is a screenshot here on screen. The yellow car at the front of shot is in second, and you can just about see me in the back of shot. I finished in eighth. So you've got second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and eighth. There's six cars there finishing very close to each other. My teammate and the Lapsusa car finished especially close together there. My teammate just about snatching fourth position by like the length of his bonnet. It really wasn't much in it at all. So, without further ado, let's move on to the standings or the results from the final round. So they're on screen now. You can see with my best qualifying position, a second, my best race position, a first, and a relatively poor showing in race two, an eighth. I managed to come third in sort of the mini standings for the final round. Moving on to the overall final standings. You can see there at the top of the driver's table is one of the SAP Racing drivers. My teammate managed to finish second. The other SAP Racing guy was third. And I finished fourth. I started this round in fifth position. And I ended up only 12 points away from third. I was very happy with that indeed. See over on the team standings, the SAP Racing cars pretty much dominated that table. And myself and my teammate, TBC Racing, finished in a pretty comfortable second position, with the Lapsusa team coming in third in that table. Down to the privateers now, and it's a congratulations to the white and blue privateer car for winning that particular section of the championship. Thank you very much for watching, as always. I really hope that you've enjoyed watching this series as much as I've enjoyed racing with it. As always, I'll see you next time in another video, and I hope to bring another championship to you at some point in the future. So, until at some point soon, Hastings out. Goodbye.